We completed a few of them. Can I hope you practiced? So we discussed up to rule 9. Rule 9 is very lengthy. So much of program is there to verify. Okay, rule number 9 we have completed. What is the rule number 9? If the switch argument is int, the allowed case labels are either int or char or byte or short. Simple, I told you one small clue to understand this rule number 4. Rule number 9. You have taken switch argument something and then case label. This value must be compatible and lesser than or equals to this argument type, then allowed here. Right? Huh. Then tell me, int, lesser type, char, byte, short, all four allowed. And next, if I take their wrapper class type, okay? Wrapper class type, if you take, then if you take here wrapper class, the allowed arguments are what? If you take byte, the allowed arguments are byte, nothing but int, int literal or char literal allowed. And next, if you take short, again, int literal, short literal allowed. If you take int literal and char literal, both are allowed. If you take char, then int literal, char literal also allowed. If you take int only, okay, if you take integer only, int literal is allowed, char literal is not allowed, we have discussed. Next, if you take enum, then enum named constants only allowed. If you take string literal, only string, if you take string as argument, only string literal allowed. Okay, these are all the points we have tested clearly in last class. I hope you practiced. Okay, almost we have written the programs, almost 236 lines we have written. So I hope all you people practiced. Now let's move to the next rule. What else more rules we have? Okay, this one already we completed, right? Rule number 10 we already completed, right? So as a case label, allowed is constant, right? Don't follow this one. Right, variable is not allowed. Variable is not allowed. Constant is allowed. Constant value is allowed. 5 + 7, constant expression allowed. Variable expression not allowed. Constant expression is allowed. Constant expression is allowed. It is incompatible. Constant expression is required. We know this. Okay, we also verified this point. After case label, right? Colon or lambda operator is mandatory. Lambda operator is from Java 12 onwards. Before, lambda operator is not allowed, only colon. So after case label or default, colon or lambda operator is allowed. Okay, this point also we verified. Right? Colon or lambda operator expected. Already we verified this point. Then next, let's see next rule. Tell me, empty case label allowed? Allowed. Already we verified. Empty case label is allowed. Okay. Empty case or default is allowed. No compile time error. Okay. Then my question, If you don't write open bracket, closed bracket, like in if, is the default go under case one? No, not like that. Okay, it is associated with a switch. Okay, then next, tell me 12th rule. Tell me empty case label with body also allow. Without body, with body. Empty case or default with body also allowed. No problem. These are all the syntax points we need to verify. Compile successfully. Then next, tell me. This is little horrible again. Do you remember if block? If block, if else block, if else if blocks. We work with variable declaration, variable assignment, right? And accessing variable after switch block, I mean if block and if else block we discussed, right? Now it's a little horrible. Working with variables in switch block. Are you ready? Oh, so many points are there. Why? 14 points are there under this rule. Okay, no problem. Let us try to see one by one. Look at there. Switch off 5, case 1, int a equal to 10. Can I declare a variable inside case without body? Can I declare a variable inside default without body? Is body required? Like in if you want to declare variable inside case, do we need to define body or not required? What is your idea? Come on, guess and tell me. Body required or not required? I will test one by one. Oh, again torture starts today. With variables again torture starts. Are you ready? Getting fear, getting happy now? When you see these many lines of code, are you getting happy now? Getting fear, again these many points, oh my God. Getting fear, getting happiness. If I am student like you, I feel so happy because I am learning so many points, depth point. So then in interview, there is no chance interviewer asking any question that I don't know, right? And if I practice this much, I can answer any question which I don't know also. If at all, if I got any question which I don't know, I can easily answer. I can analyze the subject and I can easily answer. I felt as a student like that and I will feel so happy. I don't know whether you'll be happy or you'll be, you know, feeling very unhappy. These many questions, oh my God, again. Okay, so I'm doing my duty. Let's see, will you do your duty or not? All right, so many are there. Let me do one thing. Oh, if I do like this, it creates problem. Let me remove all quickly. I don't want to give a chance to use these comments as a clues to you to answer correctly, wrongly, okay? Okay, variable related all points I have mentioned in one rule. Let's start. Tell me, any compile time error here? No compile time error, because already there is a scope for switch block. This int A, int B belongs to switch scope is there. That's why no problem, compiled. Listen, compiled. Next, can I write with body? Can I write with body? Variable declaration with body, can I write? Yes, allowed. Then what is the difference between switch with inside switch variable declaration under case with body, without body? Anybody can guess? What is the difference between them? Come on. If else concept, you know very well. Use that knowledge and try. What is the difference? Anybody can guess? What is the difference between this syntax and this syntax? Are both same? Are you there? Are you listening or not? Hey, why comment changed? Okay, now check once. chat window option got changed. Now come on, come on. Now tell me, is there any difference between these two syntaxes? If you add body, then you are informing to compiler and JVM, this A variable scope started here and closed here. Okay, this variable scope started here and closed here. Then tell me, if I don't use body here, then what the meaning of it? This variable A scope is available until end of the switch. Okay, na? Then can I access this A variable in a default for reading its value? Can I modify this A variable value in the default case? This is a very interesting point. The variable we declared inside case one without body allowed to access in another case for what? For what it is accessible? For reading its value accessible, or only for modifying its value accessible? We need to know. Are you ready? Look at here. I am writing something like this. First, I am trying to work with modification. Switch off 5, case 1 without body, int A equal to 10. Okay, then A variable declaration done in case 1, and I am trying to modify that A variable in case 2 and default case. Any problem? No problem, because A variable scope is available up to end of the switch block. Compile successfully. Look at there. Okay, compile successfully. Okay, now I am trying to read its value. Okay, with break, right? So now here without break, in switch case break will be there, na? Int A equal to 10, int A equal to 10, break. Now any error or no error? Any error or no error without break? Before without break, no error. Now with break I am trying. Any error or no error? Guess. Any error or no error? No error. Break is not the end of the scope of A variable, right? If you write break, next case is not executed. But A variable is scope is not end. All you understand? Break will stop next case's execution. But A variable scope is still available up to end of the switch. Okay? Okay. Either with break or without break, you are allowed to access in another case. Clear? Now the danger story. Look at there. I used body. Now error or no error? If I use body, scope is over here. Then case two and in the default, A variable is not allowed. Compiler throwing error, cannot find symbol variable A. Okay, now not allowed, so I'm commenting. Very nice. Now next case. Is it allowed? A variable scope. Is started here and the scope is available up to case 2 and also to switch default up to end of the switch. So can you declare multiple times? No, compiler will throw error. Look at that, variable A is already defined in method main. You cannot create again. You cannot create again. Okay, na? So it is wrong because scope is there. These are the small, small important points. Small, small, but important point. Then tell me here. I'm writing like this. What about this? Switch off 5, case 1, int A equal to 10, body. Case 2, body. Default case, body. Now program tag, compile or not compile? Now they have separate scopes. Okay, now? So it's compiled successfully. No problem. We are only verifying compilation, okay? We are not verifying output and all. Then next case is very dangerous, sir. Here confusion starts. If you practiced if else if with a variable, then it is easy. If you not practiced if else with a variable reading modifying, then it confusion. And now look at there. Is there any compile time error or not? You verify and tell. Do you have any cannot find symbol error? Will you get compile time error cannot find symbol? No. We don't get cannot find symbol because a variable scope is available in case 2 and default. Will you get any other errors? If you watch variable chapter videos completed, while working with local variable, there are three rules. Rule number one, local variable cannot access from other methods. Rule number two, without initializing local variable, you cannot access compiler throw error. Variable A might not have been initialized. Rule number three, before variable declaration, you cannot access, right? Then totally on local variable, two compile time errors will come. Cannot find symbol, variable might not have been initialized. Then tell me, here I'm reading the A value. What is the output will come? Tell me. Is the 10 will come or not? Is the value 10 will come or not? Now switch case value is what? Switch case value is what? 2. Control is going to 2. SO plane A. What is A value? 2 directly jumping here. A. Value 10 will come or will not come? Scope is available, but the value is not available. Very important point. Variable A has a scope. Memory scope is there, but it is a value is not accessible. Okay. Its value is not accessible. Now look at there. Compiler will throw error. Variable A might not have been initialized. Okay. For example, let's say here case 1 I am writing. Okay. Switch 1. 1 means what? Control go to case 1. Variable memory created and value stored. Value stored. Then moving to case 2 and SOP line A. Will it compiled or not? Earlier 2 compile time errors we got. Now will you get 2 compile time errors or 1 compile time error or no error? Let's see. Still we will get compile time error. Variable A might not have been initialized. Either you take value 1 or you take value 2. Compiler doesn't care. So what is the rule? If you declare variable inside one case, if you try to access that variable in other cases for modification, for new value assignment, no problem, compiled. But if you try to read its value in another cases, compiler will throw error. Variable might not have been initialized. It doesn't care what is the switch argument value. It doesn't care which case is executing. Simply it will throw error because the value you initialize in one case is not available to another cases. The variable you declared in the one case is available to another cases, but the value is not available in another cases. Am I right or not? Simple point here. One case and one option value, how it is available to another options? Common sense, na? If you assign one value for one case, then how that one case value is available to another case? That is a common sense point, right? Wrong statement, na? One case value should not be available for other cases. That's why compiler throwing error. Is it clear? Okay, fine. So now compiler throwing error, so I am commenting. Next, moving to the next point. If I place the scopes like this, then if I place scope to the variable, then what the compile time error? Cannot find symbol variable A, cannot find symbol variable A. Control 1, look at that. Now we'll get compile time error, cannot find symbol. Okay, nice. So now I hope you are all following. Okay, now you got the clarity. One case value should not be available to another case. But one case variable declaration available for another cases for reusability. Then look at here. Is it compiled or not now? Is it a valid code? You declare the variable common to all cases for reusability in the first case. Then you cannot use this case value in another case, but for each case I am assigning separate value. Is it valid case now? Yes. It is valid case. Compile successfully. Okay, now? Next. Next. Is it compiled? Same point, just a scope. I have defined in scope and trying to initialize. Allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Compiler will throw error. Cannot find symbol variable, cannot find symbol variable. Okay, now I am commenting. Four errors you got. Commenting, commenting, comment. Okay, fine. Then case number five. Chalo. Look at this case number five yourself and tell me, is it compiled or not? Easy, easy, very easy point. Here onwards, all known points will come. Compiler or not compiled? No, compiler throw error because you are redeclaring everywhere. So compiler throwing error. What is that? Variable already defined? Variable already defined. So now I should comment. Again, all four statements. Okay, good. Then next case. With body, allowed? Yes, with body, every variable has its own declaration and every variable has its own initialization. Compiled successfully. Okay, nice. Then next, tell me. I'm not showing output because output flow already you know. Only compilation point you need to know. What is this? Tell me, is there any compiled error? Same case again repeated, why? Is there any compile time error? Same case again repeated. Number compile time error. Which line number compile time error? Line number 48 is compile time error. Why? because the A variable scope is available up to switch. After switch, it is not available. Line number 248 cannot find symbol variable. Compile time error will come. Next, tell me. Now, int A equal to 10. I have written like this. Any error now? Int A equal to 10. If you want to access this variable after switch block, you have to define before switch. I have written int A equal to 10. Switch off 5, case 1, SOP line A. What is the output? Output 15, Output 15, 1-5. Many people are giving output 1-5-15. I don't know what they are using. Is their eyes are working or not? I don't know. A given argument is 5. Case number matched or not matched? Case label not matched. How this A equal to 15 executed, buddy? Come on, buddy. Use properly eyes. Eyes use properly. Okay, read properly. Yes, open A. What is the output? 10 you will get. Okay, last value I'm getting 10. Next, what is the output here? B value 10, case 5, case label matched with the argument, B equal to 15. Control 1, Control 2. Output is 15. What about body? What body, Nanna? That is declaration or initialization? B variable memory available outside, right? Okay, then output is 10. Then going 5, case 5 matched. B equal to 15. Store 15 in B memory. 10 replaced with 15. Right? Then control come out of switch. Still the B value is there. B memory is there and its value is there. B value reading from memory 15. Next. It is not Python language, Ray. It is Java. In Python, B equal to 15 is different. Java, B equal to 15 is different. Bolo. Compile or not compile? C variable declaration available, but initialization not there. Do you remember if true, A equal to 15 SOP line A, it was executing in if class. With the if class, it is executing, but with the switch, with the if case, okay, with the if case, it is working, but with the switch, in case of switch, it is working or not working, it will not work. Compiler throw error, variable C might not have been initialized. Declare variable outside of the switch and initialize inside switch, reading its value after switch. Compiler throw error, variable might not have been initialized. Excuse me. Now I'm writing like this. Now allowed here, case value, case label not matched. That's why C doesn't have value. Here compiler, case label, case argument is matched, D equal to 10, SOP and D. Allowed? I want to comment this first. Is it allowed or not allowed? I told you, compiler doesn't consider what is the value in the switch argument. I told you one point, switch argument is a 5 or 10, compiler doesn't consider. Switch argument, compiler read it as int value. It is one int value. What is that int value? Compiler don't know. Compiler doesn't read argument as a value. Compiler read argument as a data type. That may be 5, may be 10, may be anything. Are you catching my point? Now look at there. Line number 277, we are getting compile time error. Compiler read value as a value only in case of literal assignment, but not inside argument. Assignment operator read by 5 as a 5, but in the case of argument, it is not reading. Okay, now? Right. In the case of argument, it will not read. In the case of argument, in case of switch, argument, it will not read 5 as a 5. It will read as 5 as int. Do you remember? I told you one point. M1 of 5, if you write, is a compile read 5 as a 5? No, it read as M1 of int. It read M1 of int. Okay. Next, very important. If true, if you write, compiler will read it as if true only. This is a confusion. So small points, you know, some mismatching are there. You have to remember. M1 of a 5, compiler read as M1 of int, not as a 5. If write true, it read as a if true. Right? Same way, if you write switch off a 5, if you write, it doesn't read 5 as a 5. It will read it as switch off. It read as switch off int. So what is the value you are passing, it don't consider, it will not match with that. Okay, these are the small points by practice you have to remember, that's it. So should not get confusion. Where compiler considering literal as a literal, considering literal as a type, you have to carefully practice. Simple, in an argument, in a parenthesis, if you write value, it is considered as type. It will not consider as value. But in case of if true, it consider as, in case of if true, it is consider as if true only, value only. Okay, so next, come to this point. Can you tell me this story? Is it compiled or not? Analyze. Is it compiled or not? Analyze. Switch int. This int value may be matching to case or not. If a given value matching to case, e value 10. If a given value not match it to case, default case executed, e value 50. By the time control come out of the switch block, e will definitely has value in 100%. Think, compiler assumption. Same point we discussed with if else. Declare variable outside if, inside if initialize, else also initialize. Condition true, else if block value coming. Condition value, else block value coming. Now switch off 5. This value may be 1 or some other. If the given switch argument value matched to case 1, e value 10. If not matched, default value, default case executed, e value 50. What the output coming e? Some value coming, right? 100% we are guaranteeing the e variable value. That's why no compile time error. And what is the e value will come? 50 will come. Okay. If I write here 1, what value will get? 10 will come. Hi. Right? 10 will come or 50 will come? 10 will come or 50 will come? Switch off one, if I write 10 will come or 50 will come? 50 will come. Why? I also committed a mistake. Okay, why? 50 only will come. Why? Because there is no break, na? One is matched. E value 10, there is no break. So control will go into default case. Then 50 will come. This is a very tricky point here. Okay. Now look at there. That program I have given down. Now every case I covered, wonderfully. Now tell me, what is the output? 1-1 matched. F variable declared, 1-1 matched, F value 10. What is the F value? Generally people will feel F equal to 10, that's it. That's why more practice is required. Okay? So as many more cases you try, as many more cases you practice, that much more knowledge you will get. But the error coming? Variable D might not have been line number 277. As many more cases you would practice, that much more idea you will get. and always work like a compiler, always work like a compiler. Start from first line. Never use your eyes. Never use your eyes. Okay, always use memory diagram, draw memory, pen and paper, always use pen and paper. And now F variable memory created. Then case one matched to it, 10 stored in F, no break. So going to default, 50 stored here, 10 replaced with 50, then F value coming what? 50, okay? If you practice with pen and paper, definitely you will give right answer because your mind will do proper calculation. Okay, no? Now tell me, if I write like this, now, what the G value? What the G value? What the G value? G value now 10. Why? Because case 1, G equal to 10. G equal to 10. 10 stored in G variable. Break. Break means default not executed. Compile, execute, output is 10. Okay, now I am sharing all these programs daily, requesting you to practice. It's your responsibility. Okay, you have to prepare your own notes. I prepared my own notes, that's why I remember. You must prepare your own notes. Tell me, is this program compiled? Earlier, with only case, we got compile time error. Now will you get compile time error? This case also we practice with if call, if clause. I mean, this point also we practice with if. Already H is initialized with -1. If a switch argument is not matched with the case, it is not executed, control is coming out, H is contained the default value -1. Control 1 compile, control 2 executed, output is -1. So no compile time error. In this case, any compile time error? No. I value -1, then case 5 matched, I changed it to 10, I value is what? 10. Control 1 compile, control 2 value is 10. Okay, the next. Tell me, this program compiled? This point also covered with if else. If else, if else. I ask you to practice. If else, if else. Variable declared before if, initialized in if, again initialized in if else, again initialized in if else, initialized in else, and finally, after if else if, I am trying to read value. This program compiler throw error. Line number 338, compiler will throw error. Line number 338, compiler will throw error. Compiler doesn't care break. Only JVM know about the break concept. Compiler doesn't know break there or not there. Line number 338, compiler will throw error. All the people are feeling that, okay, switch 5. If case 2 is not matched, default case executed. You are thinking like a JVM, not thinking like a compiler. So totally how many cases you have given? 3 cases. Case number, if the switch argument matched to case 1, J value 10. If a switch value is matched with case 2, what the J value? What is the J value? No value. That's why compiler will throw error. Yes or no? Achcha, no compile time error. No compile time error. So if else if assumption is not working here. It's compiled successfully. compiler is considering break also. Okay, compiler is considering break. Okay, right. I misunderstand. Compiler is considering break. Okay, now try to answer. Now compiler considering like this. What is the value of 5? Value of 5 is something. Case 1 matched j value 10. Then moving to case 2, no initialization. Okay, now default case j equal to 30, right? So j compiler is considering the break. What is the 5? I don't know. Compiler to JVM, compiler working with Shubham Nirvan. If I write switch off 5, compiler is working with int, JVM working with 5. Compiler is working with assumptions, JVM working with actual flow. That is only the difference. Compiler working with int, this value may be matched with case 1. Matched with case 1, j value 10, no break. Going to case 2, no value. Going to default. Okay, finally, by the time control come out of the switch, j value initialized. Next assumption. If int value is a 2, if int value, argument value 2, then no value here, but default. From the default, j value coming 30. So if switch value, some other value, let's say some other 3, then directly go to default, default j value coming 30. In all three cases, how many assumptions compiler placing? 3 cases. Why? Three assumptions it is going to take here, because 3 cases you have written. First, case 1, next case 2, default case. Because there is no break, flow is going down, 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 considering. So in all cases, now we are getting value, so no compile time error. Understand the explanation? Practice, practice, okay? If you practice, you will remember all this flow. Then tell me next. Here, this program. Switch, some int, matched to case 1, k value 10, no break, going case 2. Now, in case 2, k is not initialized, 10, break. Break means it is going out of the switch, k value coming 10, no problem. Int value is what? Let's say in 2, coming 2. In case 2, there is no value, break, coming out, so error. Variable k might not have been initialized. For the assumption number, case 2, now we are getting compile time error. Okay, now, compiler verify every case. Through every case, the k must get value. If I initialize with a default value, no error, already verified. Okay, now, then, already we verified this, just reminding. Now, A6. Huh? Oh, so it's not, it's an error in declaration. Okay, so we are thinking that this as assumption, okay? We are thinking it as assumption, it is wrong. Look at that. Variable declared before switch. Variable before switch declared. Same variable, I can do assignment here, but I am trying to redeclare here. Allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Okay, in my mind, another case is there. Let me add it. Now, I'm writing L equal to minus 1, L equal to 10, L equal to 30, SOPLNL. Ambolo, is it compiled? Is this case compiled? Yes. Why? Because in case 2, already L will have the minus 1. Na? We'll get output minus 1. Compile and Okay. L value 30 will come. Because why? Default case matched. I'm giving here 2. Minus 1. Okay now? Fine. Now look at here. This program, if you declare variable inside a method, the same variable you cannot redeclare inside switch. This point already we discussed in if block. Variable already defined. Okay, I'm commenting it. Next. Is this allowed? Is it allowed? Allowed. The variable declared in the switch, I can redeclare after switch because its scope is already over. Compile successfully. What the A7 value will get? 20 you will get. And next last case. Is it compiled? Not compiled because it's local variable scope over. Okay, it's a local variable scope over. You cannot assign it. Okay, it's not Python. Don't carry Python points to here. Okay, compiler throw error, cannot find symbol. In Java, Java is strictly typed programming language. Data type you have to mention. Okay, so these are all the cases. I hope you got clarity. Final conclusion, tell me. What are the points we have discussed here? Working with variables in switch. First point, variable declaration in one case and accessing in another case. Variable declaration in one case with body, without body and with body. Second case, variable declaration in one case, accessing in another case for assignment. Assignment and reading. Next, variable declaration outside switch, initializing inside switch case and reading after switch. Next, fourth case, variable declaration outside switch, again declaring inside switch. Fifth case, variable declaration inside switch, again declaring outside switch. Right, so these are the total 5 cases, many programs we tried. First point, we can declare variables in switch case either with body or without body. The variable declared in one case without body, it can be accessed in other cases or default for assignment, even though we have used break. The variables declared in one case with body, it cannot be accessed in other cases or default, compiler will throw error. The variable declared in one case without body, it cannot be redeclared in other cases or default, compiler will throw error. The variable declared in one case with body, it can be redeclared in other cases, or default compiler will not throw error. The variable declared in one case with or without body, it cannot be accessed for reading its value in other case, or default compiler will throw error because one case value must not be available to another case. The variable declared in one case without body, it can be accessed for reading its value if we assign it in current case or default again. In another cases or default case, compiler will here error or no error? No error, no? Copy paste problem. Okay, the variable declared in one case without body, it can be accessed for reading its value in another case or default if we assign it in this current case or default. Okay, compiler will not throw error. Next, the variables declared in switch in one case, it cannot be accessed after switch block. Compiler will throw error. If you wanted to access the variable after switch, we must declare before switch, then compiler will not throw error. If you declare variable before switch and if initialize variable in one of it, in only one case or in all cases, but not in default. Look at there. This point, come on. If you declare variable before switch and if you initialize this variable in only one case, in a switch, in only one case or in all cases, but not in default, we cannot access this variable after switch for reading its value. Compiler will throw error. Why? If all cases value failed, what the value of that variable? Correct? If the given switch argument is not matched with all cases, what the value coming out? Nowhere. So simple if else. Next, if we want to declare variable before switch and want to initialize variable in switch cases and want to read this variable after switch, we must initialize this variable either with some default value at the time of declaration before switch, or we must assign it in default case also. Okay, next, if we initialize variable in switch case and also in default, if you don't use a break at end of case after switch block, always we'll get default case value. Next, okay, next point,
If we declare variable before switch completed, if we declare variable before switch, we cannot declare this variable again in switch. Compiler will throw error. Inside switch, we can either assign or read this value. If we declare variable inside switch, we can assign default. We can again declare this variable after switch. Compiler will not throw error, but we cannot assign or read value outside of the switch. Compiler will throw error. Okay, totally 14 points we discussed. All 14 points based programs are there. Okay, now. Feeling tougher, easier? Now, switch based, any question you see in the Google, can you answer those questions? Take screenshots. I'm not giving these soft copies. Only the reason I want you type. If I give soft copy, you will not type. You will just simply download and run. If you type, then only you will remember. If you don't type, you will not remember. That's why, please don't get angry. Take screenshot. 1, 2, 3. 1 second. 73. Take it. 3, 4. Five, six. Seven, eight. Nine, ten. Eleven, twelve. 13, 14. 14. I hope you will all practice. Please, today only you should practice. If you are postponing, you will face problem. Look at here. Last rule. As a case label, we use either binary or octal or decimal or hexadecimal literals. Int type na? Int type number, binary, octal, decimal, hexadecimal literal. If we use binary or octal or hexadecimal, they are converted to decimal. If the one case decimal value is equal to other case value, either by binary or octal or hexadecimal, compiler will throw error, duplicate case label. For example, if I write 0, 1, and 1. 0, 1 is octal, 1 is a decimal. Both are equal. It will throw error. If I write 0, 1, 0, 1 and case 5, 0, 1, 0, 1, 5, both are same. It will throw error. We cannot place multiple default labels. We can place only one default label. We know it. We can place one default and anywhere in the switch. We can place one default anywhere in the switch. I combine multiple points under this rule. Okay, we can place one a default and anywhere in the switch. Generally people place default at end. Generally people place default at end, but you can place a default anywhere, either first or middle or last, either at beginning, in the middle of the case, or at end. As per project recommendation, place it at end of the switch. Okay, na? So these points, just I have come in, combined 2 points into 1 point. Okay, next, look at here. Main switch off 5. Look at there. Case 0B011. It's converted to decimal value case 3. Case 01, octal number converted to 1. You can take capital B or small b. Case 77. If you write 0XA1, case 161. Understand? Next, case 5. No compile time errors here. Case 5. Tell me, are there any compile time errors here? Come on. Are there any compile time errors? It is a binary number. It is a binary number. Binary number cannot contain 2, na? Literal chapter. Binary number cannot contain 2. 2 is not in the range of binary. Throwing error. It is an octal number. 8. 8 cannot be used in the number. 8 is not in the range of octal. Compiler throw error. 7 allowed. 0x hexadecimal. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. G is not in the range of hexadecimal. So compiler try my error. It is not the case label points. It is basically number preparation problem. Okay. Integer number too large, integer number too large. It's a number problem, not a switch cases problem. Okay. Next. Tell me, I'm writing like this. It is a duplicate case, na? Case one, duplicate case. Now I'm writing like this. Any compile time error? Case 01 is a convert. It is a octal converted to decimal value is case one, duplicate case. Last point, sir. Next, case 5. No error, na? Case 01 to case 12. No error. 01 to what the value? 10. Case 012, decimal value is 10. And case 12, different case labels. So allowed. Compile. Now, I am giving like this. Any error? 014, case 12. Case 014 and case 12. Error or no error? What happened again? You stopped giving reply. Again, chat window disable. No, no. Come on. 014. This is 8. 8 plus 2, 12. 12, case matched, throwing error. Duplicate case. Rabaji, okay na? I'm writing just case 5, case 1. Allowed? Any error? No error, na? Why I have written it? Okay. Only default. Only case, allowed. Only default, allowed. Okay na? Tell me, if I write only case, is this case one always executed? No. If I write only default, is it always executed? If I write only default, is it always executed? Yes. It is not matched with any case. Default always executed. And next, can I write case one, case two, case three like this without default? Yes, allowed. Then if a given argument matched to one, case one, no break, case two, case three. If a given argument is matched to case two, case 2, case 3. If a given argument matched to case 3, case 3. If a given argument not matched to anything, nothing executed. Okay, next. I'm writing 2 defaults. Allowed? Not allowed. Compiler will throw error. Duplicate default label. Duplicate default label. Okay. Next. Case 5. Now I'm writing case and default. Allowed? Not allowed. Duplicate case label. Duplicate default case. Next. Now I'm writing case order, not following order. Case 2, case 1, case 4, case 3. Can I write like this? Any zigzag order? Can I write zigzag order? Yes, no problem. So similarly, can I place default case in zigzag order? Place default last, allowed. And next, placed default at beginning, allowed. Okay, allowed. And placing default in the middle, also allowed. Okay, all these things you have to type, sir. Prepare your own notes. I am writing default and case 5. What is the output we will get? Hello, hiya, hi, hello. Output is hi, hello, na, hello, hiya. Only hello or only hi? This is very interesting. If I write default as a first case, both executed. No. Default always executed if case is not matched. Default is always executed if case is not matched. Not first to second middle, okay? Right. You forgot the point. Case 5, it is matched with 5. Hello is the output. Control 1, control 2. Ayo. Should not forget that point here. Tell me now. I am writing like this. Now show your talent. Okay? Now show your talent. Tell me. Default to case 1. Now 5 is not matched with case 1. Then default executed. After default, case 1 also executed? Or only will get hi or hi hello also? Hi hello, both will come. Once case executed, down case is executed, break is not there. Output is hi hello. Next, tell me. If I write break inside default, okay, multiple cases, then no case is matched, then 5 default hi hello hello, 2 times will come. Okay, na? Generally, people will teach these points at the beginning of the switch, but I will teach these points at end. First, I will teach the most horrible points, and last, I will teach easy points, and also I will teach, you know, most repeatedly coming points. No, your mind will work as a stack architecture, na? Your mind will work with stack flow, no? Last in, first out. That's why these points for easy remembering purpose, I am telling now. And tell me now, default case is not matched with, output is hi, hello, hello. Same point, no? This program, 2 times came, why? No, difference is there. Here I taken case 5. What is the output now? Only hello. Last hello will come. Okay? And the next. If I write like this, flow understood, right? Matched with this case, hello, hello, 2 times will come. Okay. If I write like this, last case, you'll get output only hi. Control 1, control 2. Amaya. Switch related, all points are completed. So, switch argument cannot be a variable declaration but variable assignment is allowed. As a switch argument, the allowed things are literal variable, variable name, variable expression, method call, literal final variable, constant expression. Switch argument type must be either int or its lesser range type or wrapper classes, enum switch, enum string. If you pass long float, double boolean, long float or compiler throw error. Like if we cannot create switch without body. Like if we cannot, we can create switch with body. Case default or optional. Inside switch without using case or default, we cannot place any statement. We must place statements only under case or default. We can place only default without case. We can place only default without case. We can place case and default in any order. Case 1, 2, 3, default case 1, 2, case 2, default, default, okay. Here A equal to 5, so only default executed. Here A equal to 5, so default is executed. If you don't place break in default, case 1, case 2 are also executed. Here A equal to 5 and case 1 are executed if break is not there in default, okay. If you place default at last, case break is not required. If you place default either as a first case or in the middle case, we must place break. Else next case logic is also executed as shown in above programs. We must use a case and default only inside switch body. Okay, we cannot use them directly inside method compiler throw error. After the keyword case, we must place some value, either compiler will throw error. Next, after the keyword default, we must not place some value, compiler throw error. Like a switch argument, a case label value cannot be variable. A method call and an expression compiler will throw error. Like switch argument, the case label type must also be byte short carry into string literal enum and enum constant. Okay. Case label type must be compatible and it range must be lesser than or equals to switch argument type argument. Okay. If you use a string as a switch, the allowed argument label only string type. If you use enum as a switch argument, the allowed label must be enum constant. If you use wrapper class bytes, okay. Okay, here program I copied above as it is. If you use wrapper class integer, the switch only allowed label is int. Program, I didn't update, only return point. If we use a binary octal by hexadecimal literal, we can, as a case level, they convert to decimal value and use it as a case level. We cannot create duplicate case. Like empty case, which we can also place empty case. During variable inside, declaring variable inside, okay. So just I'm seeing, are there any new points here, missed anything? Outside switch, initializing inside case, okay. Creating same variable in multiple cases. Executing some logic for multiple cases. Now tell me, this is very important here. Look at here. Sometimes I want to execute same logic for multiple cases. Executing same logic for multiple cases. Okay, right? Case test, M1 method, switch A. 1, 2, 3, leave like that. So this way also you will write. Sometimes you will see this logic. Be careful. Please take screenshot. Okay. If you want to execute multiple, same logic for multiple cases, you write 1, 2, 3, logic break. Nested switch block. You can write switch block inside switch. Then the case switch A plus 1, case 1. So with nested switch, again you need to verify the variables declaration. Outside switch variable can be accessed when switch. Inside switch variable can access outside switch. Okay, you try yourself. So take this one also, sure, screenshot. Okay, na? So this is the story about a switch, and requesting you all, please go through websites. Okay, go there. Switch. MCQ. MCQs in Java. Don't try in another languages. Okay, Java switch case entry MCQs, control flow statements, switch case and answer questions, switch statement, flow control Java program MCQs, Java program multiple choice questions. I am not going to answer any question. I want you try yourself. Top 20 MCQ questions on control flow statements, quiz on conditional operator and switch. So just you try now. Okay, now is the time, 5:30. Remaining 20 minutes, you yourself work on if, else, if, else, if, else, if, else, if, else, next, switch, inner, if, else, if, inner, switch. Okay, on these 7 concepts, you only try your own examples on by following this website, and tomorrow we'll start loops. Understand? Tomorrow we'll start loops. If I teach everything now, we'll get problem. Okay? Then, while loop, do while loop. You know, almost every point of if else if is coming inside while again. So that's why please practice these five keywords and their inner concepts. Okay? So that loops will be easy for you. Remember, once the loops completed, means control flow statements completed, I'm expecting you to start work on logical programs yourself. Number based programs, character based programs, pattern based programs. Okay, these three concepts you only should work. I'm not going to help you to develop any programs. Are you catching my point? You have to work yourself. I'm not going to help you anything. You have to search in the Google and you have to find. I given sufficient full knowledge. Next, array and vararg. Now arrays, after control flow completed, array program I'll give. On array based programs, then you are going to work with searching and sorting algorithms. Array based programs and searching and sorting algorithms. So these are 100 plus programs. You have to prepare your own material, your own programs you have to prepare. I am not going to help. This is assignment to you. Chapters I'm teaching, small sample programs I'm giving, then go through different websites and collect the programs and practice yourself. Is it clear? Thank you. This video will be uploaded to YouTube. From there, if you miss taking screenshots, you can collect from there. Okay? Complete chapter I'm uploading to YouTube. From there you can collect. Thank you. That's all for the day. See you tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll start loops. Thank you.